Hello, I'm Indy, and welcome to a new Let's Play, this time of a little indie game called It'll Do. This will be a little bit more of a straightforward playthrough. There's not much known about the development of this game, so there's not a lot of trivia, as it were. But we will just have a little fun with it, so without further ado, let's go with It'll Do. Well, my little sidekick doesn't seem to be too happy on the raft there. Puck. Okay. At least he saved the potion. And apparently we are on the island. Well, would you look at that? An entire island just reeking of adventure. I wonder how that smells. I'm sure hope that's adventure I'm smelling. Is there a swamp nearby? Who cares? Let's check out that dirty old cave. Right, I'm taking a nap in the tipsy button. Call me if you need me. So Tipsy is apparently my little fairy helper there, if you compare it to Zelda. And this is basically what this game is. It's a little indie Zelda clone. And this, like I said, will be a pretty straightforward playthrough. I actually wanted to play a Zelda game, but then I got very worried about copyright strikes, so I decided to play something else. Something similar, but something else entirely. Tutorial Cave. Adventurers, welcome. Okay, let's get in here. We do have a map. Okay, very interesting. Yeah, most of this will be pretty reminiscent, I think, of a Zelda game. We have a door, but I don't think we can walk over spikes here. No. It is a little bit more puzzle-orientated, though. There's a floor switch nearby. Yes, dear game, I already figured that out. Thank you very, very much. Hint, walk into some blocks to push them. We can do this. This is all very basic, straightforward stuff. Light the torch with your burning stick to open the door. There we go. We are not letting anyone through. Word. Oh boy. So don't try smacking that magic crystal sleeping over there. Beat stuff up until we solve the puzzle. Got it. I'm still burning though. Okay, do we have some kind of inventory? Not really. Okay, we're gonna figure this game out as we go. I have a couple of years ago played this game already though, if I'm totally honest. But I don't remember any of it. I know I enjoyed it, but that's about it. So this is not as blind as it could get, but pretty blind as far as I'm concerned. Smack doors and gates for clues on how to open them. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, if you smack that, there goes a little line to the crystals. And that goes to the enemy. So my Zelda intuition would say that I have to kill that enemy, that creature there. To open the door. There we go. I get a little heart. Wow, he just eats it. Okay, that's just sick. Is that a heart? Where did you get that? From the ground. 3 second rule. Don't eat stuff off the ground. Oh, 5 second rule. I thought it was a 3 second rule. Never mind. Carrying on. Yeah. Imagine Link always eating the hearts that he finds. It would be a little bit creepy, wouldn't it? Okay. Things are getting a little bit more complex here, as we can see. Let's just for now keep reading the signs though. Press down both floor switches at once. Okay, we can do that. I hope. There we go. Why do we have that second one though? Can I pull these things? No. Well, that was a bit weird. Let's go back to see. Why would this block be here though? Because I cannot pull. Bit weird. Yeah, this game was released on July the 5th in July the 5th in 2013. And it's made by a little Swedish company called Ludosity. We apparently are at the map screen here, the overworld. North to the castle, west to the fish bun hills, and east to the swamp. So there is a swamp. I'm guessing I cannot do this yet. So, north it is. North it is. North to the castle, east to the desert grove. We cannot go east, so we continue north. Can I do something with the trash can? Doesn't look like it though. Let's look at this neat little cottage here. Oh, we can enter it. It's a pirate! Arr! Wow, look at all this total crap. Okay, didn't remember that it was so humorous though. An adventurer, I'm item carver, and this is my shop. Carved all these items myself, I did. Savvy? What? Even the swordfish? Especially the swordfish. So what do you need? A raft, please. I'd rather not be stuck here if the adventuring isn't up to par. Oh, but of course it is. The most adventuresome island you ever saw, arr. Tell you what, I'll carve you a raft for free if you can bring me something called the artifact from the castle up north. In the meantime, I bet there's lots of gold in the castle too. Go get some, then buy something. Okay, so this is basically a store. An ice wand for $400. Portal wand, fire sword. Okay, I need a lot more money though. Wait. Did I just took the. I think I took the back exit there. Yeah, I did. The warp garden. Ah. Okay, these are teleportation things to probably go to every dungeon. Back to dungeons or something? Probably. Yeah, like I said, I don't remember much of the game, so we'll have to figure out this stuff as we go. The castle. So I guess this is the first real dungeon? Okay. Think this is indeed the first dungeon, and I do like that we get a hand-drawn map there. Yeah, it looks pretty neat. The first time I ever saw this game in screenshots, I wasn't too sold in the art style, but when you see it in motion, it looks rather cool. See this area? See this area behind the spikes? I'm guarding here. Okay. You're lucky I'm not guarding over there right now, or I'd have to stab you with my spear. This is the castle security. At least they won't care if when we loot the place. Do I have to do something with them? Okay, let's just go through this a little bit structural. Not like that though. This way. Shop at items. What can we do with the bombs? Probably have to let them explode, but we can't really do much else. Okay. Okay, let's see. Do we have to. There we go. Don't need to eat the heart, though. Yes, as I remember it, combat is not the main focus in these dungeons, though. It's all about these little rooms, puzzle solving. Okay, I need to bring fire. And I'm going to assume that this will work if I stand on the third one. Okay, that brings me back to the main hall. It worries me a little bit that I don't get any money drops. Oh, we could go to the right here. I totally missed this room. And it opened up something else, but I cannot go through this. So, do they expect me to go back to the store? But I haven't found any money to buy something. Music is kind of cute. Oh, there's, of course, there's fire right here. And I can probably do the same thing with the bombs. There we go. Not the hardest puzzle in the game, but I actually managed to already get confused. Wonder if we will have enough time, because it does look. No. Okay, it doesn't look like we have enough time to do that, because the room will reset each and every time. We appear to have some ice blocks here. And they just keep sliding till they reach something. Okay, not sure why I could do that. Yeah, I was really in the mood to play some Zelda stuff for the channel here, but we all know how Nintendo feels about YouTube and stuff like that, so I decided not to take the chance and just play something that kind of mimics it instead of playing the real thing. Bombs and torches love being set on fire. It's what they live for. Okay, good to know. Can I move them? I can move them. But everything will be reset once again. So this doesn't have much use for me. Okay, we now got money. And a lot of money. That, if I have to guess, will be $200, right? Yeah, there we go. And this will take me back. Ooh. They took our lunch money! No! Arr! Now that's the pirate's line. This is more of a Arr, no! Or something more like that, I think. Okay, let's see if we. I think there was a fire sword or something like that. A magical blade that's always on fire. It's yours for only $200. Luckily, I found a chest with $200 in it. Okay, I actually have to go. That was actually pretty funny. What? Okay, so we're now in another dungeon, it seems, where we. The Toasty Cave, where we need to solve, I guess, this dungeon to get the fire. This way, professional shortcut. Okay. This is pretty interesting, to be honest. Wonder what professional shortcut means, though. Get the fire sword, go west. Ooh, he seems to be on something. Okay, let's hit this and see what it does. It tells me to light the two thingies, but I cannot do much with that. Oh, they immediately give me the fire sword. It can melt ice and light bombs and. Okay. And it did replace. Yeah, I don't really have an inventory as far as I know. So it did replace my stick, though. That's interesting. Why would I have these blocks here, though? There is probably a way, a professional shortcut way, to get that block on there. Maybe if you already play the game or replay the game right immediately, you learn some tricks along the way, and you can take a shortcut, maybe. Not sure how that exactly works, that professional shortcut. I guess I'm not professional enough. Do like the music. And the store page, they sell the game as having gorgeous wobbly graphics, and I kind of have to agree. I do like that style. Everything, every object that isn't the background seems to wobble a little bit. Yeah. It's pretty cool looking. Can I hit that guy? I guess not. Let's see what the sign says. Block the enemy's path. So far, if they're gonna keep giving me hints, this will be a little bit too easy. So for now, let's just not read the signs anymore. And if we get stuck for some reason, then we might just read the sign. These are weird little blocks because, so far as I know, I cannot pull them. This is all pretty straightforward, though. Nice little chain reaction there. As far as I can tell, this is basically the only way we can really go, right? I'm gonna guess I have to put out the fire. Yeah, and this is probably the best way of doing that. For now, I feel rather smart with myself still, but this is probably gonna change fast enough. Some of these bigger rooms do have some frame rate issues, it seems, but nothing major. And luckily, we've got a snake on the floor there pointing us in the right direction. Otherwise, I might have been already a little bit confused here. So far, so good. So far, so good. And we have another one of these psycho miners. First things first. Okay, pretty straightforward. There's a way to the right here as well. I cannot do this from this side, I think. The only thing I can do here is put that block on the right fire there, and that's not enough. Ice travels across spikes. Well, that's good to know indeed. And actually, we do need to know that because we cannot do anything else. So we need to do this then. Yeah, there we go. That's really hot. Yes, don't touch the lava. Let's see if we can block his way. Well, that actually exploded the blocks there. Didn't expect that, though. Okay, what else do? Oh, that brings us back to this room. So my guess here now is to is to put out both of the fires. So how are we gonna do that though? Because this I get. But how? Ah, there we go. See, it's getting a little bit more complex, and I have to think about it a second. So it's not going to be a very easy progression here, I think. Oh, spooky lining. Ah, mademoiselle. What is that supposed to be? Dead are dogs at Farfira over. I cannot understand that. Okay, that's probably a good answer. You don't know what that means, do you? Nope. Neither do I. Let's fight. Okay. Okay, we do see the pile of torches there, so that's probably important. Okay, did I actually hit him with the bomb there? Well, let's get rid of all these enemies. I probably have to do the same thing again. Okay, this is pretty easy. Chop, chop, chop. Oh. What are these things? Pancakes or something like that? Chop, chop, chop. Okay, how many cycles? Let's go for three. I think three is more than enough. What do you guys think? Ooh, that's not gonna work. Can I actually hit them with my sword, though? I didn't even try that. Okay, come to me. Okay, let's hope he stays there long enough. There we go. Three cycles was more than enough there. Okay, what does the chest giving? Tipsy's tips. Hey, it's a piece of paper. Tape that thing to your life bar and let's find some more of them. Okay, so it's basically a heart container piece. So we need to find three more for a full heart container. And I guess we just solved our real first dungeon, I guess. For your convenience, there are no items or chests you can miss in the dungeons. That's actually pretty decent. Did I actually do everything? Not really sure. I might have to explore some more if we have some more items or something. It does tell me that I can't miss anything, so I might just go check it out again and then if I find something new, come back or something like that. Or that's maybe better for another time. For now, I think this was a great introduction to this great little game, and I hope you enjoyed it. So leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!